Warning, this content is contagious, tenacious, and a bit outrageous. If you can give less of a shit, then welcome to the Flaming Shaft. Okay guys, as you can see, this is a new series to the game. It's called Don't Starve. It's by Clay Entertainment. Can't really say it properly, but pretty much it's a lot like Minecraft. It's a survival game, except for you don't really, like Minecraft, you don't really start off with anything. You just start off with absolutely no knowledge. Okay, so as you can see next to the new game menu, there's a little dude. His name's Wilson. This is Wilson. He's a gentleman scientist. Each character, as you can see, there's more than one, has their own technique or their own special ability. Wilson's is he grows a magnificent beard. So what happens is how you can unlock these guys is by, once you die, it calculates how many days you survived, and depending on how many days, it will unlock characters for you. So I think it's like 10 to unlock this one. So yeah, let's start. So yeah, if anyone's not sure, I am UrShadowFlame, and I'm from the Flaming Shaft. But the other person in it, who is part of the channel, is the TheFlameGuardian. He is currently sitting near me, but he is not in this recording, due to the fact it's single player, and he just doesn't have the game. We also have our co-bitch, HoneyLicious. You might have seen her in the first video. She is mainly does Sonic videos, actually. You should go check her channel out. But she will be in pretty much most Minecraft videos we make, because, you know, she's awesome. Yeah, so the game's just loading, as you can see. And it's taking its sweet ass time. Okay, that was Maxwell. He is, I think, the person who put you in this world. This weird 3D/2D world. So, okay, we're really lucky because we actually began right near a save point. And these save points, there's only going to be a few of them throughout the world. And they are called Touchstone. And they're surrounded by pig heads on sticks. Because, you know, why not? When you activate it, when you die, instead of just the game ending like it normally does, it will break open and you'll come back to life. But these only work one per death. So that means I have one extra life right now. So yeah. So for the first episode, we're just going to collect stuff because the first episode, well, not first episode, sorry, the first day, we have absolutely nothing being done. We're just going to get stuff like flint to make axes and pickaxes. So yeah. So now we have enough for a axe. And we need wood to make a fire for when the night, well, when night comes. And yeah, so we don't die. That would be a good start. So as you guys can already tell, up in the top hand corner it says day one. And that will, you know, last one day and then it'll go to day two, if that's not clear. And see the little red bit on day one? That is dusk. That's when you can still walk around and stuff, but it's when mobs start to either come out to prey or go to bed and hide. And then the blue is when it's nighttime. So yeah, we're just grabbing some... Don't. Okay, that's a turkey, and he is, I love the sound he makes. As you can see, he's eating all the berries, because he's a jerk. He's really hard to actually catch, because he is incredibly fast, and he runs away from me the second you go near him. I love the sounds he makes. But yeah, one thing about this game is I think it has really lovely music and sounds. It just sounds really cool. And at night time it gets very, best word probably used to describe it would be creepy. Because it starts, I don't even know what it does something that makes it just seem that little bit more eerie. But yeah, so I think we should follow the path. What the hell is this? Okay, this is some... Oh. Okay. This is new. Okay, I've never seen these guys before. Normally the pigmen are not hostile. Normally they will not attack me. They will run away from me. And right now, if I go near them, they try and kill me. So, save king, must defend, I protect. Okay. So I just need to make sure I have enough for fire. So, because... Okay, so I do. Because it's starting to get dark and I don't really want to die on the first day. That would be embarrassing. I will warn you guys that I have never actually played Don't Starve on non-edited mode. Like, normally I turn the bosses off and stuff because I'm a pussy. I don't know how to survive very well with bad guys. So, yeah. So, I haven't turned them off this time. So, I will be brutally honest with you guys. I'm probably going to die very shortly. Probably in a few days. As soon as the dog things, shadow dogs, or whatever the crap they're called, come out, they'll probably just kill me straight off. I won't know how to defend myself, and I will die. So, as you can see, it's dusk at the moment, and the screen's got darker, the water's got darker. Yeah, pretty much that's about it. And you start to hear some strange sounds, and you start to lose sanity by running around in the dark. With this game, if you don't keep your food up high, and you don't keep your health up high, or even your sanity up high, you will instantly die. Something will kill you, whether it be hunger, you know, dying from being hurt, or by losing your mind and having shadows kill you. Either way, this game likes to find as many ways as it can to kill you. So yeah, I think in the first 2 days our main mission will be to find what I actually just found. Well, when? Okay, so we're gonna probably set up camp around a pigmen village, I guess you can call it. And what it is with pigmen, they have this thing where they don't like you, other than the ones I just saw that try to kill me, and they tend to try and back away from you. And because of this, they're good because they are a very mild mob. They only attack you if you attack them. And by doing this, they will also attack the hostile mobs that go near you because they think that they're trying to attack them. So by setting up camp right near them, they are pretty much your guardians. Okay, well right now, because it's about to be nighttime and I don't want to die, I'm going to set up a campfire. Because if you don't have a campfire when nighttime comes, you will get eaten by, I think, these things called Alices, which are like shadow creature things that will just eat you. Well, just the second you get in the darkness, they'll eat you. So yeah, I'm just going to add some fuel and I'm going to cook some food because my hunger's already gone down about a quarter, maybe a third. Okay. And just so you guys know, there's a lot of stuff that you can actually end up getting with this game. Like, you can have a full-on base. You can... One thing that we will be making as soon as we get a proper base is a science machine. And by doing that, we can unlock a lot more stuff like traps, farms, etc, etc. All the stuff that's got little locks on it, you can unlock quite a few of them. You can even start doing magic, but the problem about doing magic is you start to lose sanity. But yeah, soon I would like to also get this thing called Chester. You might have seen it in my thumbnail. He is the cutest little thing. He's a chest that has a mouth and is pretty much a dog, but it's a chest that follows you around if you're holding this thing called an eye bone. And when we see one, I'll tell you. And by holding it, he will be your personal, I guess, portable backpack kind of thing. Unless you set down your backpack, sorry, the bone, and then Chester will sit where the bone is. Because that is like his squeaky toy, I guess you can say. So yeah, night time's almost over. That's good. Okay, so as you can see, when you get to daytime, it normally automatically saves for you. So this is where we've been so far, and we haven't really been that far. And yeah, that's my map. So we're going to try and find our pig village today, and as soon as we've set up a base, we will end this episode, because I'm just going to make it short, just so I don't bore you guys. So yeah, so as you can see, I'm using a slightly better microphone today, as I have stolen HoneyLicious' microphone. She has been kind enough to lend it to me, because my microphone sucks balls. And hopefully by my birthday I might at least have enough money to buy myself some good headphones or good microphone, whichever, you know, works better. Okay, so there's some bees. I have a frog chasing me. It's trying to tongue me to death. I'm just gonna get some flint because we need a pickaxe. Yep, okay, now we have enough to make a pickaxe. So by doing this we can get stone and then here we go. We have found the one in a map time eye bone. And this Chester will be here shortly. You can hear him bouncing. Yep, there he is. Hey Chester. When you open him, as you can see, he has 9 slots for you. And as you can also hear, just by the sounds he makes, he is quite dog-like as he pants. And he sits there, and his little tongue hangs out of his mouth. But yeah, this is the eye bone. So yeah. So I guess we should just explore. Hopefully come across some rocks, and we'll get some stone. And possibly gold. That would be good. Okay, so... yeah, Chester makes little bouncy noises when he follows you. So eventually that might get annoying, but you know what? He's too cute. Keeping him. Sorry guys. Okay, so there's a rock. I'm gonna get some. So just so you guys know, with this channel, we're hoping to do as many gaming videos as we can. The next game, other than Minecraft and Don't Starve, that we're probably gonna do, is I think I'm gonna make the TheFlameGuardian play Unfair Mario, because he doesn't know what it is, and he's hilarious to watch rage. That will be the next game, hopefully, we'll upload. And yeah, this is my own little series, so I don't really think until the Don't Starve Together comes out, which is the next Don't Starve game, that is where you can play multiplayer. And when we play multiplayer, you'll see some more people playing with me. But until then, I've just got my own mini series. Okay, so this is really weird, but this is a dark flower circle, and there's always some weird, stupid item in the middle. Yeah, but as you can see, when you go near the circle, your sanity starts to drop because it's evil and, you know, for some reason, dark things make us sad. Yeah, but Don't Starve are very original. They call their items that they have no use for ring thing and potato thing. A ring that can focus dimensional energies. Oh, maybe this actually does have use. Okay, one more. I'm going to put this in Chester, because I have no use of it right now. I'll put this in. Okay, so it's getting dark again. That kind of sucks. So we'll just set up a chest in a sec. And depending on if there's anything particular I want to talk to you guys about, but I might just skip night time so you guys don't have to watch me sit there. Yeah, also, you know, save time. Okay, so we're still not finding anything. That's really annoying. I was hoping to end off this episode with some good piggy action. So yeah, I'm just running around. Sorry, I'm just getting criticized for calling it piggy action. AKA, I want to find pig houses and set up a camp near their homes and, you know, make them my bitches. The Flame Guardian's just mocking me right now. I don't think you guys can hear them, but you might be able to. I hope not, because, yeah, still not finding anything. I think when it gets to day 3, I might just have to end the episode and we'll just continue next time, because I'm just not getting anywhere and the time's running out, and yeah. So, it's a, okay, we've come to the limit of this little island, so that kind of sucks. We have, at least we have chests though, we've got something. Okay, as you can see over there, that is a swampy biome, I think it's called. And by that terrific sound of demon spawn, that was a spider. And they either sit in their nest during the day, or if you try and come near their nest, or they can come in at night time. And last time I tried to record this video, because last time it failed due to my crappy mic, I had about 7 spiders try and kill me on the 3rd night, and I just survived, so. Okay.
Come on, come over here. Damn it, I'm low health. Okay, I just had my best.
So this is the end of episode 1. I love you guys. You guys are the best. You're my little shafts. And yeah, see you next time.